Good morning, everybody. Congresswoman Kaptur, Ukrainian ambassador, and other members of this important political body, not just to the United States, but to the world, and especially to Ukraine, as it fights a very aggressive adversary, both yours and us, Russia. Thank you very much for not abandoning our veterans and considering their great human needs. America has seen battle and knows what it means to be on the front lines and to return. I have learned something about your veteran programs from fellow US chaplains, like my good friend Chaplain Major Terry Bell, who is here and came from Tennessee to support me. I started my chaplaincy ministry 5 years ago. It started with Maidan, the revolution of dignity. In 2014, I was a student of Kyiv Orthodox Theological Academy, located on the territory of St. Michael's Golden Dome Monastery in the center of Kyiv. When the peaceful participants of the revolution were beaten by the police and firearms were used against them in February 2014, the monastery opened in gates. The church could not stand apart from those events and, in fact, publicly testified that it was together with its people. The monastery became a hospital and sanctuary for the wounded and the exhausted. Those who were murdered on the Maidan were also brought in. I helped to lay the bodies of our heroes in the monastery garden. We searched through their private belongings to identify the innocent killed by the snipers. With Maidan came the call for a better government for Ukraine, but Russia responded with an invasion. It annexed Crimea and started the war in the east of Ukraine. Together with volunteers, the priests became chaplains and moved to the war zone in Donbas. The chaplaincy became a powerful movement. Priests organized some of the first aid for the fighters. They collect money, bought military equipment, ammunition for those who went from their town or village to war. During the early days, there was no other aid. Most importantly, they visited combat areas themselves, personnel to support our defenders, pray together and show they were not alone. The General Staff of the Armed Forces of Ukraine reports that more than 5,000 priests of different denominations have done voluntary rotation in the combat zone. In 2016, the priests started officially working as a chaplains in the army. They are constantly present in the combat brigades, in the military bases, in the military hospitals, in the military educational establishments. They see the combatants off to the front, visit them there, and meet them upon their return. Our military priests greet all veterans, men, women, old, young, without discriminating along age, nationality, or religion. The chaplains join to programs organized by local government or some organization. Unfortunately, there are not enough services to go around, so they initiate the creation of specific programs for veterans. But not enough. There is not enough money nor experience to handle the large numbers of wounded and psychologically harmed veterans and their wives, husbands, widowed, and orphaned children. The Orthodox Church of Ukraine has a synodal department of the military clergy. It is a structure that promotes chaplaincy. One of the important areas to its activity is working with veterans. I would like to briefly talk about one project that has already been started to create a veteran center in the city of Cherkasy. The center offers different programs to the families of veterans and military personnel in the region that help veterans to return to civilian life, overcome alcohol problem, avoid family disruption, and find work. For children, there are kindergarten and various sport activities. There is also housing for those who came from far away. The Veterans Center is created and works with the participation of civilians with mandatory presence of a chaplain. It is non-denomination veterans. Veterans of all religions who are in need can get help. Because of Russia aggression, the number of veterans is only increasing. Unfortunately, the number of broken families, alcohol problem, PTSD, suicide is gracious too. We must respond to this. We need a variety of veterans organization, center, programs that can help veterans deal with PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, integrate civilian life, get guidance, find a job, get medical, psychological rehabilitation, and more. The war is sure to end, and all fighters will become veterans. They will remind with their stories of physical or psychological wounds. Unless they get help, this war will not end for them, and it will it ever end at all. We already have too many cases where it has not ended. There is not help for them, even though they are no longer on the front. This must change. Before coming here, I asked some newly returning defenders of our country that they needed. One of them said after a long pause, "We need to be remembered, not abandoned. The church will continue to be with its people. The chaplains will continue to be side by side with our defenders, reminding us of their needs as they live for the front during their harsh deployment there and when they return, because we are stronger together. Dear American friends, we can be stronger with your help. Slava Ukraini!"
Thank you. Thank you, Your Excellency. Thank you, Reverend Father. On behalf of everyone here, thank you for all of your work as chaplains within Ukraine's military.